So the reason we opened up with that cell phone video is because, ladies, the number one danger lurking in your purse, cell phones. So raise your hands if you have a cell phone in your purse right now. It also applies to men, and there are many reasons why. Cell phones are awesome. I don't know how we could go through our daily lives without them. But, Doctor, what's one reason why they're so dangerous?
All right, we're going to first start off with contact dermatitis. Allergies, a reaction to the metal. And what most cell phones have is nickel in it. You can have contact dermatitis to any contact with any type of metal. It can be jewelry, it can be earrings, it can be piercings. Millions of people develop contact dermatitis. The number one offending thing is nickel. The dead giveaway, if it's your cell phone, if you develop this rash irritation on the side of the face, exactly where you're holding your phone, the contact of the phone causing that allergy, you have your diagnosis.
Same for acne, though, right, too? If you're doing this and you get a whole bunch of acne right here.
Well, because you may get bacteria on the phone, too, and then you're putting bacteria on your skin, which in turn get inside your pores, leading to a breakout acne as well.
And therein lies the problems with cell phones. They go everywhere with us. And as they go everywhere with us, touch every part of our bodies. Yes, they do. They touch every possible surface. Not only can they cause contact dermatitis, but they pick up bacteria and viruses along the way and other potential pathogens. 94.5% of phones in one study were shown to carry a bacteria that was potentially resistant to antibiotics. How often do you wash your cell phone or clean it off? Not often. One study showed that only 10% of healthcare workers clean their cell phones. Now, we're different because we host the show. So now I know we all go home at night and use alcohol swabs to wash our phones. I do. Mm-hmm. I have to admit, 5 years ago, I didn't.
No.
But now I do, and there's a reason why. MRSA, methicillin-resistant Staphylococcus aureus. That's a mouthful. But you can't see it on your phone because it's invisible to the naked eye. There are a couple of different types of MRSA. One you get in the hospital. The other's called community-acquired MRSA. It can cause some pretty significant skin infections. And the reason that we call it MRSA is it's resistant, meaning it's resistant to certain antibiotics. Probably one of the easiest ways to transmit it is particularly these pop-top phones. Or what's this called?
Flip phones.
Because how often do you clean this inner surface, right? I haven't had a flip phone in years. Jamie, what do you...
You still have a flip phone?
The good news here, Jamie and everyone else, is it's pretty easy to clean off your phone at the end of the day. Just you can use an alcohol-based cleaner.
Yeah.
We've even shown on the show before some of those ultraviolet lights that can clean your cell phone. Your cell phone doesn't need to be a danger if you take care of it the right way.
Well, there's one more cell phone danger, and that is fecal matter and E. coli. If you're taking your cell phone to the bathroom, doing your thing, you're gonna get E. coli all over it. And that's a problem because E. coli is a nasty bug. It causes upset stomach, food poisoning, and it's so easily transferred from your hands to the doorknobs, your cell phone, other people.
A lot of people think, well, if I get a little, allergic reaction, it can be cured with something, or antibiotic reaction be cured, but it can really cause something that gets deep, gets hard to cure with antibiotics, and actually can cause a scar.
Yeah.
So, it's important.